you all are fine, and I hope you understood the previous part of human health and disease, the chapter 8 of class 12. Now, today in today's video, I'm going to describe about the immunity part, where I will be describing about the antibody structure, antibody molecule, immunoglobulins, type of immunoglobulins, their function, and even about the various allergy and lymphoid organs. So try to understand this topic and keep watching. Children, today's topic is immunity. It is a part of human health or disease. Now, today I'm going to describe about the types of immunity and about the structure of antibody molecules. Now see, first let me define about what do you mean by immunity. Immunity is the ability of the body, body means host body, to fight against the disease causing pathogen or disease causing agent. This is called immunity. So immunity is the ability of the body of the host to fight against the disease causing agent. Now this immunity can be divided into two types. The basic types are innate immunity and acquired immunity. Now, innate immunity, what do you mean by innate immunity? Innate means it is non-specific type of defense. Non-specific defense which an individual is born with and which are always available to protect the body. So it is non-specific for the defense, and it consists of major four type of barrier in our body. That barrier prevent the entry of pathogen or foreign element into our body. So you see, the four elements are physical barrier, physiological barrier, cellular barrier and cytokine barrier. Now let me describe each one by one. First is physical barrier. Now see, I have given two examples, mucus and skin. Physical barrier means skin is the first physical barrier, or it is the first line of defense. It prevents the entry of the pathogen into the body through the skin. Now mucus is present in our epithelial lining of the respiratory tract. It is also present in the epithelial lining of the gastrointestinal tract or in the urogenital tract. So this mucus helps in trapping microbes and play a specific role in physical barrier. Okay, next come physiological barrier. Physiological barrier are few in number. You see, tears of our eyes, saliva secreted from our mouth, acid secreted by the stomach. So these are certain type of physiological barrier that prevent the growth of microbes. Next comes cellular barrier. Now this cellular barrier includes special type of cells in our body which kill the disease causing agent. Now these cells are mainly, you have seen, I have written one PMNL. What does it stand for? It is a type of neutrophil, that is polymorphonuclear leukocyte. Polymorphonuclear leukocyte is a type of WBC, that is neutrophil. Even there are monocyte, natural killer cells. It is also a type of lymphocyte in our blood that generally acts as cellular barrier. There are even macrophages in our tissues that also act as cellular barrier. Next come the cytokine barrier. Now see, when the cells are attacked by virus or infected by virus, these infected cells which are infected by virus, they release some protein which are called interferon. Now these interferon protect the non-infected cell from further viral infection. So that is called cytokine barrier. I hope you understood now. Next, let's topic is the acquired immunity. Again, see, acquired immunity is divided into two types, active immunity and passive immunity. Clear? Now, active immunity, you see, what is active immunity? See, it is the immunity which develops in our body when it is exposed to an antigen, which may be in the form of living or may be in the form of dead microbe. Okay, or it may be in the form of protein. So, antibodies are produced by the help of this, in this case. Okay? Now, introduction of any type of pathogen or microbe either during immunization or during any type of infection in our body, that is active immunity.
Clear? Now it is again divided into two types, artificial and natural, that I am going to discuss.
Now see, this active immunity, it is very slow process, but long lasting process. And this type of process do not have such side effects. So you see, artificial immunity means this is the immunity produced during vaccination. So it can be developed in our body by vaccination. Natural immunity, it is developed during natural infection, naturally when you are getting infection in your body and the immunity grows against that particular disease, that is the natural immunity. Next come the passive immunity. Passive immunity means it is the immunity which is produced by antibodies that are directly given to the body. So it is very fast acting but lasts very for few days. So it is only a short span of time. So for example, you see antibodies that are received by fetus, okay, from the mother to the placenta. So from the mother to the to the fetus through placenta, this passive immunity can be passed. Next come you see colostrum. I have written one from colostrum. So colostrum is a yellow fluid secreted by mother during initial day of lactation. You know, now in colostrum there is a large amount of IgA, immunoglobulin A. So immunoglobulin A is rich in colostrum, that also provide passive immunity to the children, those who are breastfeeding. And that's why it is said that after the parturation, after the delivery of the baby, breastfeeding is compulsory to grow passive immunity among children or infants. Clear? Next come, the next topic is immune responses. Now what do you mean by immune responses? Now immune responses, see, majorly it is divided into two types, the primary response and the secondary response. The primary response, it is the response which is generated when a body encounters a pathogen for the first time. So suppose your body is encountering a virus or a bacteria for the first time. So in this time, this intensity is very low. First of all, when the virus or the bacteria is entering the body, the intensity may be low. After every primary response, the cell memory, it stores the detail of the encounter of the bacteria or the pathogen. Clear? So this is the primary response. So once again, I am repeating it. It is the response generated when a body encounters a pathogen for the first time. It may be a bacteria, may be a parasite, whatever. So it is of the low intensity. Now after every response or primary response, the cell will store the memory in details of that encounter that happened in your body for the first time. Next comes secondary response. Okay. Now it is the subsequent encounter. Means off and on the encounter may take place in your body of the same pathogen. Okay. And as a result, a secondary response will be created. It is highly intense response. And the memory of the first response, the first encounter, it will help. Okay. In the intense secondary response. That means when the primary response is over, after many years or after many days, again the secondary response takes place. Means that again encounter the same pathogen take place, so that secondary response will take place. So it has the capacity to distinguish between the self and the non-self or the foreign molecule or the cell. So primary and secondary response, they are carried out by two type of lymphocyte. Now what are the lymphocyte? B lymphocyte and T lymphocyte. Okay. Now, how can you classify this? This can be classified as humoral immune response and cell-mediated response. Now, you see, first let me tell you about the B lymphocyte, or it is also known as B cells. Now, B cells or B lymphocytes, these lymphocytes are produced like an army of protein. Okay, now these army of protein are called antibodies. Now these antibodies in response to pathogen, they are produced in our body. Now these antibodies are found in our blood. And T lymphocyte or T cells help the B cell to produce the antibodies. Clear? So T cell help the B cell to produce the antibody. So this is the action of the secondary response and the primary. So as I was telling about humoral immunity, now humor, what do you mean by humor? Humor is blood or lymph. So this is humoral immunity. Now let have a look at the various differences between active and passive immunity. Now, as I told you, active immunity is developed due to contact with the pathogen, okay, or it's any antigen. Now, if any antigen or any pathogen, maybe it is a living or a dead state, it enters our body and that leads to production of antibody in our host cell, that is active. Passive means it is developed when ready-made antibodies are injected into the body. Okay, so here ready-made antibodies are injected in our body. Secondly, you see, in active immunity, it has only few side effect or may not have any side effect. While in the passive immunity, it may cause a reaction in the body after the passive immunity is given. Okay, I think you have heard about administration of tetanus antitoxin, tetvag injections, many of you are aware about. Now, this administration of tetanus antitoxin, it produces fever in your body for a few days, isn't it? And there is a very much pain in the place where the injection has been put. So, this is the reaction that I was talking about. Now, the third point about the active immunity is, I told you already, there is a slow process but long-lasting process. While the passive immunity is a very fast process but lasts only for a few days. Okay? Now, in active immunity, see, it takes time to develop a response. But in passive, when it is given, the immune response has to be very faster, and that's why it is given. So this is about active and passive immunity. Now see, we are talking about antibody and antibody. What is this antibody? Now antibodies are actually certain proteins. Okay. Now they are protein molecules. They are generally known as immunoglobulins. Immunoglobulins. These are actually known as antibodies. Okay, now see, immunoglobulins are mainly of five types. Okay, what are the five types? Let me write IgA, immunoglobulin A, IgM, immunoglobulin M, IgE, immunoglobulin E, IgG, immunoglobulin G, and IgD. So these are the five type of immunoglobulins, or what we say as antibodies. Now, generally an antibody has a Y-shaped structure. You see, I have drawn here a Y-shaped structure. This is an antibody. Now, each antibody molecule has four polypeptide chains. Now, these four polypeptide chain, two are the long chain and two are the short chain. See this, this is the four polypeptide chain. 1, 2, 3, 4. These two are long chain, these two are short chain. Light chain, these are light chain, these are heavy chain. Clear? So this is about the structure of the antibody molecule. Now you can see, now antibody molecule, hence we can say H2L2. H2L2 means two heavy chain H2, two light chain L2. So you can write down two heavy chain, two light chain. L2. So these are heavy chains and these are light chains. See, I have marked here light chain. Okay, this is the antibody antigen binding site. This is the antigen binding site on the both side, you see. Okay, now see IgG, that is immunoglobulin G, is the most prevalent antibody in the blood, followed by IgA and IgM. And IgA, this is the most abundant found in the colostrum that I told you just few minutes ago. Now, let me discuss about the function of all the five types of antibodies. First is IgG, immunoglobulin G. Now, this immunoglobulin, it is the most prevalent immunoglobulin found in our body. Now, this immunoglobulin, it is about comprises 75% to 80% of the total amount of antibody produced in our body. Now, what is the function? Function is, it protects different type of fungal, bacterial, toxins in our body. It can cross the placenta from the mother to the child and can provide immune response or immune protection to the newborn baby. It is also responsible for the Rh factor in our blood. Rh factor, you know, Rh positive, Rh negative blood groups. So this formation of Rh factor is responsible for this is the main function of IgG, that is immunoglobulin G. Next come IgA, immunoglobulin A. Now this is the second most prevalent antibody. It is nearly about 15% of the total antibody produced in our body is IgA. Now the function is, you see, this is secreted through various lining of our body system where mucus is present. Clear? Now mucus is secreted from nose, eyes, lungs, saliva, isn't it? And even our tear gland. So, or even see digestive tract. So these are the places where IgA is found. And it is found also in the colostrum, in the breast milk for the newborn baby to protect the newborn baby from various type of pathogenic infection. Next come IgM, immunoglobulin M. This is the third most prevalent antibody, which is produced nearly 5 to 10% of the total amount of antibody produced in our body. Now see, they are the first to be produced in response to encounter with a pathogen. Means when a pathogen enter our body, it is the first immunoglobulin to create a response in our body. Okay, now this is responsible for blood transfusion reactions also in the ABO blood system. Okay, now if there is a mismatch blood transfusion, then there will be severe immune response, okay, reactions taking place in the body of the person. Next come IgE, immunoglobulin E. This is the very least common type of antibody found. And it make up to only 0.002% of the total antibody produced in our body. And this is mainly involved with allergic reactions in our body. Okay, next come IgD, immunoglobulin D. Actually, it is not understood properly about what is the function exactly the IgD do. But it is said that there is signal the B cells to be activated, and thereafter the B cell create immune responses. So this is about IgD. So these are all the functions about the all immunoglobulin molecules. Next topic is vaccination. Now I hope you have heard about vaccination. Clear? Now what does vaccination means? Now the basic principle of vaccination is the immunization, which is based on the antigen or antigenic protein or pathogen which is in inactive form, which is introduced in our body. That means a pathogen in the inactive form, okay, is introduced in our body that may create or induce very mild immune response in our body. So the vaccine thus generates antibodies, okay, isn't it? When the pathogen in the inactive form introduces in our body, then it generates antibody. And that neutralizes the pathogen during actual infection that happens in our body later. So this also generates memory cells, that is T cell and B cell, that recognize the pathogen thereafter after the subsequent infection. Okay, so this is actually the logic of the principle of working principle of vaccination. Clear? Now next topic is autoimmune diseases. So what are autoimmune diseases? So I was talking about autoimmunity. Now, what do you mean by autoimmunity? Now, it is a state when the body loses the ability to distinguish between the self cells and the non-self cells. So, the body's immune system goes off the track when the train sometimes go off the track, okay, and get destroyed, many passengers die. So, like that in our body, when our body become unable to recognize which is the self cell and which is the non-self cell. So what happens gradually? The body's immune system goes off the track and start destroying the self cells. Okay, and the self molecules in our body. And as a result, this damages the body and resulting in autoimmune diseases. Now there are various types of autoimmune diseases. Here I am discussing three types. First is Addison's disease. Next is rheumatic arthritis, and last is Hashimoto's disease. Now what happened is Addison's disease. In Addison's disease, actually the adrenal gland do not produce enough hormones due to autoimmune disorder.
Okay, so you know very well what is the function of adrenal gland, adrenal hormones produced by the body in the adrenal gland. Next come rheumatoid arthritis. Here what happened, there will be chronic inflammation of the joints in the body. The various joints of the body present will be having inflammation. So there will be unbearable pain and inflammation. Okay. Next come Hashimoto's disease. Now here the immune system attacks the thyroid gland. Now as a result there will be a leak. Okay, leakage in the thyroid gland, and that will cause the excess of thyroid hormone secretion. That is hyperthyroidism will take place in Hashimoto's disease. So these are the three types of autoimmune diseases. Okay, now see the next topic is allergy. What is allergy? Now allergy actually it is an exaggerated or hypersensitive reactions. It is an hypersensitive response which are caused in our body due to allergens. Now what are allergens? Allergens means allergy causing agents. Now this can be like dander, old skin or scales, maybe pollen grains, maybe dust, maybe even mites. Okay. Now here what happens, see, as I told you earlier that IgE plays a major role in allergic reactions. So what happens, see, when our body encounters any type of allergens, the IgE type of antibodies, they produce this response. Now what happens, what are the symptoms? Symptoms are, see, first there will be watery eyes, rashes, maybe there will be sneezing, continuous sneezing, there will be running nose, there may be difficulty in breathing. So these are the various type of symptoms of allergy. Clear? Some of you may have the allergic reactions for dust or some particular food product. Okay, now allergy occurs due to the release of the chemical. Can you remember the name of the chemical? It is histamine and serotonin. So when allergic response takes place in our body, chemicals like histamine and serotonin, they are produced from the mast cell. You have heard about mast cell in class 9. So what happens, see, sometimes the drugs like antihistamine drug or adrenaline or steroid, these are given to the allergic patients to quickly reduce the symptoms of the allergy. Nowadays you see what happens, allergies are mainly very common, especially in the children of the metro cities. Why? Because of large number of pollutants everywhere, and the immunity is also low. You see these people nowadays in the cities, the children often very very seldom they come out of their house and play and they do exercise. So even the environmental pollution is very high and the lifestyle is also very different from the previous times. So as a result you see allergy response is very prevalent nowadays. So for determining the cause of allergy, the patient can go for an allergy test. The patient is exposed or injected with a small dose of the allergen and then studied the effect in the body. So students, I have come to the last part of today's topic of immunity, that is components of immune system. Now there are major four components of our immune system. The first is lymphoid organ, second is immune cells, third soluble molecules like antibodies, and fourth is lymphoid tissues. Now lymphoid organs. Lymphoid organs are thereafter classified into two types. Primary lymphoid organs, which include bone marrow and thymus gland. And second is the secondary lymphoid organs, that includes the three type of lymphoid organs, that is spleen, lymph nodes and MALT. MALT means mucosal associated lymphoid organs. Remember this abbreviation is very important for you. Okay, now let me discuss about each lymphoid organ. Okay, so first is the primary lymphoid organ. Now see, what are lymphoid organ exactly? Now you see, organs where lymphocytes originate. Lymphocyte cells originate, they proliferate and then they get mature. Okay, in these organs, so these are called lymphoid organs. So lymphoid organs are those organs where the lymphocytes originate, proliferate and get mature. Now primary lymphoid organ. Primary lymphoid organ, here the immature lymphocytes, they differentiate to mature antigen. Okay, so they mature to antigen sensitive lymphocytes and then after maturation, these lymphocytes migrate to the secondary lymphoid organ. So in the primary lymphoid organ, the lymphocyte, immature lymphocytes, they differentiate mature, okay, mature to mature antigen sensitive lymphocytes are converted into, okay, and then they after maturation, they transfer to the secondary lymphoid organ. Okay, now what are the two major primary lymphoid organs? Just now I told, bone marrow and thymus. So you see the location of the bone marrow. This is a bone marrow. Inside here maybe bone marrow. Okay, and the lymph node here, maybe in the throughout the body there may be lymph node. Okay, so lymph node. Now you see lymphatic vessels. Now you see what is bone marrow. Now bone marrow, it is the main lymphoid organ where all the blood cells, including lymphocytes, are produced. Clear? That is the site of B lymphocyte maturation. Next come thymus. Now thymus is a lobed organ, you know, which is present near the heart. Okay. And it is beneath the breastbone. Now it is very large in the time of birth. But with the age goes, the size keep on reducing and become very small when we attain puberty. So growth and maturation of the T lymphocyte takes place in the thymus gland. You know, for the infants, the thymus is much bigger. It produces immunity. Next comes secondary lymphoid organs. So spleen, lymph node and MALT. Now what are the secondary lymphoid organs? Now these organs, they provide the site for the interactions of the lymphocyte with the antigen. So in the primary lymphoid organ, the here the lymphocytes were actually, they matured and then they differentiated. Here in the secondary lymphoid organ, here the interaction of the lymphocytes takes place with the antigen, so which then proliferate to become effector cell. Okay, now the secondary lymphoid organ, spleen. Now spleen is a large bean shaped structure. Okay, now it's a bean shaped structure. So you see this spleen, this produces lymphocytes, which are phagocytes, and large number of erythrocytes also. So it filters the blood by trapping the blood-borne microorganism. So whatever blood-borne microorganism passes through the spleen, it is filtered there. Okay. Next is the lymph node and thereafter MALT. So the last two are the lymph node and the MALT. Now lymph node, see, these are very small solid structure. You see, I have drawn some lymph node here. So they are very small solid structure. They are located at different points of our body along with the lymphatic system. Okay, there will be lymphatic tissues, lymphatic vessels. So these are solid structure which are present in our body. Now their function is to trap the microorganism, okay, or other antigens that enter the lymph and tissue fluid. Now this trapped antigen in the lymph node, they are responsible for activation of the lymphocyte present there and cause the immune response. Clear? Now that is called lymph node. Next come mucosal associated lymphoid tissue, that is MALT. Now this is located within the lining of the major tract in our body, like the respiratory tract, okay, or the digestive tract or the urogenital tract. Now this MALT, they constitute about 50% of the lymphoid tissue in our body. Okay. So these were all the types of lymphoid organ in our body. So in the next video, I will be talking about the non-communicable diseases like HIV/AIDS, the life cycle of the AIDS virus. Okay. And the preventive measures and the high risk pupils. Then I will talk about the cancer. And the last video, I will be talking about the drug and alcohol abuse. So try to understand this topic. I hope you found it interesting. So thank you.
Children, I think you have understood the part of immunity, the various type of antibodies, immunoglobulin molecules, the structure, and various terminologies here which are associated with immunity. So keep watching the videos, and in the latter part, in the latter video, I will be describing about the non-infectious diseases like cancer and AIDS, and thereafter in the last part I will be talking about drug and alcohol abuse. So keep watching. Thank you.